All right, so today we're going to be talking about Dijkstra's algorithm, which is a graph algorithm for computing shortest distances. And specifically, it's when you have one source and you need to compute the distance to all possible nodes, like this. So the real practical case would be something like networks and information in between nodes. Another one could be if you're a first responder, or let's say Batman, and you need to calculate your response time to any distance in a city. So yeah, this is when you use Dijkstra's. It is not an approximation, so whatever shortest distances that you get to each one of these nodes is in fact the shortest one possible. So it is optimal in that sense. So let's do a purpose. So the purpose of Dijkstra's is to compute all shortest distances from a single source. Okay, and I've already written up the pseudocode. This one is from the standard algorithms textbook, but each one is a little bit different. And essentially, let's walk through the algorithm and figure out how exactly this works. The first thing that you have to do is initialize a single source. So this means that you have to find where you're starting from. You know, in Batman's case, it's going to be the Batcave. So you do that, and that's more of just like a programming check the box thing, and it doesn't really do anything in terms of the algorithm. Then you have to keep track of what you've already seen. So what this does is this sets up a set of previously evaluated elements. And in plain English, you can say, keep track of what I've seen. Say what I've done. So notice that this is evaluated and not seen. And the difference is, when you see an element, that means that you found a path from A to B. It doesn't mean that you found the best path from A to B. So you actually have to go through and evaluate each element, even if you think that you've already found a path. So this is the set of things that you've already done. And the next thing it does is it sets up a queue for things that you have left to do. And so this is going to be a minimum priority queue, where the distance of, the length of the path is the priority. And this essentially allows you to follow the shortest path. Okay, so then you've got this while loop that says that while there are elements still in the queue, you need to extract the minimum using the priority queue to get the shortest path, add it to what you've already done, and then look at all adjacent vertices. So for V, that is an element of you being your minimum, relax. And relax just means, is a fancy word to say, update your info. Okay. And you keep on going through this until you have gone through each and every one of your vertices that you added at the very beginning. And you stop when all vertices have been evaluated. Stop. So let's go ahead and go through an example. So. So let's say that this is your graph. We'll say B. 2, 7, and 9. All right. So let's say that this is our directed weighted graph, and A is going to be our source. So the first thing that we have to do is to create our set with nothing in it of stuff that we've already done. And I'm going to denote that just by squaring things in. So anything squared is in that set. And then we add everything to the queue. So A, B, C, D, E. A is our source, so our distance is going to be 0. So we have to give priority to all of these different values. We don't know if we can actually reach any of these others, so we're just going to say that their distance currently is infinity. So we come down to the priority queue, we pop off A, which has a distance of 0, and add it to what we've already done. So A has two adjacent vertices. So you can either go to B at a weight of 10, or you can go to D at a weight of 5. So 10 is less than infinity, so this gets updated to 10. 5 gets is less than infinity, so that gets updated to 5. Alright, we still don't know if we can get to C and E, so these stay infinity. So we go back to the top of the while loop, and the next thing that gets popped off is this 5. And that gets added to Q. So now we are looking at this node. And so here we've got three arrows coming out of it. The first one has a weight of 3 going to B. And you have to add its current weight already, plus whatever the weight of the edge is. So in this case, it would be 5 plus 3 is 8 going to B. 8 is less than 10, so that gets replaced. The next one is 9 going to C. 5 plus 9 is 14. That is less than infinity. And the next one is going to E at a weight of 7. We've gone through that iteration of the loop. Next one's going to be E at a weight of 7. That gets popped off. And now we're looking at this one. This has two arrows coming out of it. The first one goes back to A, which would be a weight of 14, but we don't care about it because this is already 0. And the other one has a weight of 6. 7 plus 6 is 13, going to C, which is in 5. Next iteration, 8 gets popped off, and so now we are at B. All right, so B has two arrows coming out of it. First one coming down to D, so that would be 8 plus 2 is 10, but right now we've got a weight of 5, so we don't update that. And then the second one comes out to C at a weight of 1. 8 plus 1 is 9, so this gets reduced to 9. So now we only have one thing left in our queue, and it is in fact the C node, and this has one arrow coming out of it, which is the 4. So let me see here. C, 9 plus 4 is 13 going to E. We don't update because 7 is less than 13, and now we've finished that off. So we've now evaluated all nodes and our while loop stops, and now we have the distances, the shortest path between A and every other node in our graph. Any questions? Yeah.
So what would happen if the line from D to C was a negative 9 instead of a 9?
So Dijkstra's is not really designed to handle negative weight graphs. If you have that use case, Bellman Ford is probably a better option. It won't technically fail unless you have a negative cycle graph. But again, it won't necessarily be optimal because Dijkstra isn't designed for negative weights.
So the current algorithm finds like all the shortest paths from one source, can adapt it to like find the shortest paths from multiple sources?
So that would be a different algorithm. Dijkstra is specifically for one source, but it could be modified, sure.